takedown heading as test NG, test next generation. Takedown heading as test NG, test NG, test next generation, test next generation, test next generation. Text next generation is created. Okay, see, normally whatever the test cases we write, until now whatever the test cases we are writing those test cases inside a main method. We write that inside a main method and we execute that. Imagine that if there are some 50 test cases and each and every test case is having some 10 lines of code. Totally there are 500 lines of code is there. Or else some each and every test case might have 100 lines of code. Totally there are 5000 lines of code is there. If I have written and in between if it fails somewhere, is it that easy to track where the failure is happening, how to fix it and run the remaining things again and again? Is it that easy to do that work? No. It's quite difficult when there are huge set of lines. Then what to do in that case? What to do in that case? That is what we are going to see in real time. In real time, we won't use any main methods at all. We won't use any main methods at all. We will not be using any main methods in real time. Without that, how can we achieve that? We can use testNG for that. We can use testNG for that. TestNG, test next generation for that. Now, TestNG, test next generation, is created by a scientist called Cedric Biost. Cedric Biost. Is created by a scientist called Cedric Biost. Testing is invented by a scientist called Cedric Biost, and it's a testing framework which can be used for both black box testing and white box testing. Any kind of testings we can use that. We can use TestNG with Selenium to achieve robust automation. Okay, then discussing much about this TestNG, what I am going to do now is I am going to start installing this TestNG and start writing small programs using TestNG. Then we'll see how to implement Selenium inside this TestNG and all those things. First, how to install this TestNG? Go to Eclipse Marketplace. In this Eclipse Marketplace, search for TestNG. Search for TestNG. Search for TestNG. Then click on, there will be an install button like this. Since I have already installed, it is getting this. Install button. Click on install. Install now. Click on next, next, next and install. So that it will get installed. So that it will get installed. Now, when we are installing this, half through the installation, you click on next, next, next. In between, it will ask you, I accept. Click on next. That green color progressing bar, it will be keep on progressing. Half through the installation, you will get a pop-up which says, content is unsigned. Do you wish to continue? It's just a warning. It's not an error. It's just a warning. It's not an error. Click on install. Click on install. Install. Click on next, next, next and install. Half through the installation, you will get a pop-up which says content is unsigned. Do you wish to continue? Click on OK and proceed the installation. Right click new class. Sorry. let me create a new project. There are a lot of programs in this project itself. It is getting messed up. That's why I can create in that also. Then let me create a new project. Demo test ng. Test ng. Right click test ng, sorry, go to new package demo pack, click on finish. Here, class name, I'm going to name this as customer. I'm going to name this as customer. And click on finish. Here, let me name this as create customer method name. See, when you are creating any test ng methods, sir, any test ng classes, first time it will show you this error. Click on this and click on add test ng library so that error will go. Click on add test ng library. Click on this and click on add test ng library. System.out.println. Create customer. Create customer. Create customer. Create customer. Create customer. Run this. So create customer. Now what will be the output of this program if I run this? If I run this, what will be the output of this program? Create customer. Is it so? Is it in main method? Then how it will run create customer? As per our assumption, nothing will be the, should be the output. But when I run this, see the output. It is just printing as create customer. Forget about the remaining things. It is giving the output as create customer. Why? What is the reason? Because this method is prefixed with something called @test_annotation. This method is prefixed with @test_annotation. That, yeah, of course, that this method will become like a main method. Yes. Now I can have one more method also. Delete customer. Delete customer. Delete customer. Now if I run this, what will be the output of this program? Right click, run as test ng test. What will be the, sorry, what will be the output of this program if I run? Create customer and delete customer. You can have many other test annotations also. That is what it understood. Yes or no? Create customer, edit customer, edit customer, edit customer. If I run this, what will be the output of this program? Test ng test. Create customer, delete customer and edit customer. Create customer, delete customer and edit customer. But we are not expecting the output like that. We are expecting the output as create, edit and delete. Right? Why? What is the reason why you are getting output like that? It is not based on the order when we have created. We have created delete customer first. Most of them things like that. That's not the way. If you have many other test annotations, by default it will run in alphabetical order of the method names. Alphabetical order of the method names. Understood? Yes. So that's why it is running create customer, delete customer and edit. Sir, if I run like this, if the customer is getting deleted, then later on I will not have a customer to edit. Then how to do that? How to rearrange that order? That we will see later. As of now, what we have saw how to install this test ng. How to install this test ng, how to write a small Java program, small test ng program. That is what we have saw. Let me run this. Method, that's a method. This is called annotation. At the rate test is called annotation.
So like we can reuse those methods.
Reusing not necessary. If it becomes like a main method, we cannot reuse anywhere, right?
It's like a main method.
But there are multiple main methods here because I am using at the rate test here. I can have multiple also here. Okay, understood? Okay, let us see some notes for this up to here later on. Yeah, we should not write main method at all in real time. If you want to run that, then you should have that at the rate test. If you don't want to run, then you don't want. Test ng, test next generation is created by Cedric Biost and is a testing framework which can be used for black box testing and white box testing. Test ng provides features like multiple test execution, comma assertions, comma results and execution control. These features are essential part of automation and we can use test ng with Selenium to achieve robust automation. Installation of test ng. Open Eclipse, go to help. Eclipse Marketplace, search for test ng, click on install, next and install now. Half through the installation you will get a pop-up which says content is unsigned, do you wish to continue? Click on OK and restart Eclipse. Every test ng class should have @test annotation which will ensure the class can be executed. There can be multiple methods in a test ng class but each test method should have @test annotation. By default all the methods of test ng class will get executed in alphabetical order. Okay, let's take them. completed this? Okay. Take it. Yeah, tell me. Who is that, Dilip Babu?
Yes,
manual testing. You have to attend manual testing classes. Quick. Have you completed everyone? Okay. Next. Now when I run this, I am getting the output like this. Create customer, delete customer and edit customer. But what I need here is, I need the output like this. Login. Just a minute. Now, I want the output as login, create customer, login, create customer, then log out. Login, create customer, log out. Then login, delete customer, log out. Log out. Login, edit customer, log out. I need the output like this. I need the output like this. Before each and every scenario, I need to log in. Before each and every scenario, I need to log in. Do the scenario, log out. Log in, do the scenario, log out. Log in, do the scenario, log out. Like that. I need the output. But if I write a program like this, will it work out? Login, login, we can't edit, right? That we will see it. How to rearrange that, we will see later. As of now, we need the output like this. Log out. Log out. login. One, do the scenario and log out. Login, do the scenario, log out, log in one, do the scenario, log out one, then log in two, do the scenario. Do the scenario and finally I need to log out. I need to log out. Log out to. Log out to. That's it. Login, do the scenario, log out. 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 If I execute, if I run this program, will I be able to get the output like this? No. Why? What is the reason? It runs in alphabetical order. If it runs in alphabetical order, the output will be create customer, then delete customer, then edit customer, edit customer, then login, login 1 and login 2, login, login 1 and login 2, log out, log out 1, log out 2. That is how the output will be. Login, login, do the scenario, log out. Login, login, do the scenario, log out. Login, do the scenario, log out. I am not getting the output like that. How I am getting the output if I run this? Right click, run as test ng test. Create customer, delete customer, edit customer, customer, edit customer, login, login 1, login 2, log out 1, log out 2, like that. You can do that also, you can do that also. Sometimes it will take cache, that's the problem. I am doing like this, okay, but I don't want the output like this. My output, I am expecting in a different way. In that case, what to do? Before each and every method, actual methods I need to execute. Login. Edit, delete, like this. Now if I run, right click, run as test ng test, create customer, delete customer, edit customer, login. Here now also I am not getting the output like that. What I am going to do, at the rate, I am going to add an annotation called at the rate before method. I am going to at the rate after method. Now if I run this, right click, run as test ng test, what happens? First anyhow login, do the scenario, log out, login, do the scenario, log out. See, first when you run this directly, it will come and pick all the other test annotations. First it goes to the create customer. Before executing create customer, it checks any before hook is there for the method, which means before method is there. Yes, it is there. It will execute this. Then it will execute create customer. While it is about to exit, it checks any after hook is there for the method, which means after method is there. Yes, it is there. Then it will go to the next alphabet, delete customer. Before deleting this, any before hook. Yes, it is there. Login. Then delete customer. Then after hook. Then it will go to the next alphabet, edit. Any before method, yes, then edit customer, then log out, then finally there is no more methods to execute, it will come. This is how the execution happens. Before method, in the name itself, it is clearly mentioned. Before each and every at the rate test annotation, run that once and leave it. Understood this, everyone? The purpose of before method and after method. Okay, finally I have achieved the output like this. Finally, I have achieved the output like this. Now, first, I need to open the browser initially. Browser initially, and finally, I need to close the browser. Close the browser. Open the browser initially and at the end close the browser. In that case, what you have to do? If, let me do that. Initially, open the browser. 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 And at the end, I need to close browser. And I need to close browser. Close browser. Close browser. Open browser. And at the end, I need to close browser. Now, if I run this, what will be the output of this program? Will I be able to get the output like this? No. Yes, sir. Is it so? At the rate test. Why you think so? No, you can that rearranging, you can write it anywhere. That's arranging doesn't. Does it going to run in the order how I arrange the methods? It runs in alphabetical order, but if you have any extra annotations, it works accordingly. Then how can you assume? Okay, at the rate before class. Before the entire class, this method will get executed. This method after class. After class. If I run this, see. When you run this, run as test ng test. Open browser, login. First, as soon as you run, it will come here. Before it runs the class, it checks any before class is there. Yes, it is there. It will execute. Then it will pick all the other test annotations. Yes, it will pick three. Sorts in alphabetical order. Go to the first create customer. Before checking, executing create customer, any before method is there. Yes, create customer. Then after method. Then next alphabet, delete. Before method, delete. After, then edit. Before, edit. After, then finally close the browser. This is what we have to do. Finally, while it is about to exit the class, it checks any after class is there. Yes, it is there. It will execute and it will come out. That is how the order of execution will be, and you will be able to see the output. Before class, in the name itself, it is clearly given. Before the entire class, it has to get executed. Before the entire class, it has to get executed. That is what we have to do. Now, yes, save this. You can rearrange wherever you want, you can write it, but it is not going to run as per this order. Are you getting this?
Yes.
After class, that's it. Let me run this. Open browser, login, create customer, delete customer, like this. This is how. If there are either precondition and postcondition for the test, we can code them in two different methods with at the rate before method and at the rate after method annotation. If there are multiple test methods, at the rate before method and at the rate after method will get executed for each test in that class. If there are either pre and post condition for the entire class, we can put them in two different methods with at the rate before class and at the rate after class annotation. Take down this, then you can take down the program and including the output as well. Including this output as well. Okay, take down this.